Right, Paul, you mentioned green chemistry. It's groundbreaking research. You are a pioneer in advancing green chemistry. But what is green chemistry, and would you highlight some of the 12 principles of green chemistry?
Certainly. So green chemistry really is the scientific topic that I've devoted my professional life to. In a sentence, green chemistry is defined as the design of chemical products and processes that reduce or eliminate the use and generation of hazardous substances. So more than anything else, it's a design protocol to ensure that we get all of the function that we want from our products, we get all of the capabilities and performance that we want from our products, but not the unintended consequences of excessive waste and toxicity and risk that has been, historically a part of the products of modern life. And so this is something that's been developed over the past, 20 years. And there are networks around the world and research networks in over 30 countries. There's now 4 scientific journals devoted to the topic. It's being taught in universities around the world. You can even get a PhD in green chemistry. And so, but I think most importantly what's happened is that this has been adopted by virtually every industry sector, ranging from energy and transportation to agriculture and plastics and everything in between. So that's the good news, is that it's shown that you can make environmental and economic progress at the same time through thoughtful design. I think the better news is that they're scratching the surface of the power and the potential of green chemistry. So for every one product that has been reinvented and redesigned, there are probably hundreds that have yet to go through this protocol. So I think the upside is very high, and some market analysts have projected by the year 2020, the green chemistry sector itself will be a multi-billion dollar industry. So the 12 principles of green chemistry really do focus on not only the efficiency of a process, how you use less energy, how you generate less waste, but also the inherent nature of whether or not something's renewable, whether or not something's toxic. And it is used, as I said, as a design protocol to ensure that we're doing not only innovation, but we're doing innovation that's sustainable.